process. You can join us. Many of you have. We thank God for you. You welcome as a part, as an honorary member of the White House family. You can pray with us, live, podcast, video, lay across the bed, with your Bible, on the way on your way to sleep. I know I have put many people to sleep. If they waited till they eat, it's a great way to go to sleep, by the way. Praying and reading the Bible. Listening to somebody else pray and read the Bible. It's beautiful. It's okay. You don't hurt my feelings. Many people do that. And so you can do it too. And we welcome you as an honorary member of the White family. We thank God for you. We appreciate you. And you can, you know, families, many of you have gotten away from it. We need to get back to it. Some of you don't even know what a family devotion is. We need to start it in your home if you want your family to survive. That's if you want your family to survive. If you want to treat marriage like a shoe store and you want to try on this marriage, this man, this woman, like your parents, like you should, you know, trying on some shoes, then go ahead and do that. But that's going to be a miserable, painful life. So pray together in the morning and read the Bible. Do it with us or do it with somebody else. I have encouraged pastors all across the nation, all around the world. You ought to be in front of your people every day, not just on Sundays now. Nope. Not just on Wednesday. Some of your pastors don't even go to Wednesday night service itself. You don't go to prayer. And you need to turn the Wednesday night service not into a Bible study. We don't need more knowledge. We need more light. We need more fire. You need to turn it into a prayer meeting. You need to create a prayer list of all your members and give everybody a portion of that prayer list, and y'all need to be praying. And then pray for all of the people in the community. And every godly pastor who's not in it for the money, who's not a charlatan, what did Jesus call him? Start with an H, I think. Not a hireling. I'm not talking to you all. But every godly pastor ought to be, don't worry about trying to bring anybody to the building. That's dumb. Quite frankly. Don't need to do that. But online, you need to be in front of the people every day. You ought to have a prayer meeting and a devotion. If you want that pull away from your crowd, I'm not worried about that. God will have here who he wants to have here. I don't want anybody else's church members anyway. I'm trying to reach lost people. We thank God for people from other churches coming. I always tell them, go to your church, if your church is having church, not to the building, but online. And every pastor ought to be before their people every morning, every day, having a prayer meeting and reading the Bible through scripture. They don't have to take as long as what we do. That'll be beautiful. So today, beloved, we're reading in the Word of God, Lamentations chapter 4, Jeremiah chapter 29, and Ezekiel chapter 20. Dr. D.L. Moody said that the Bible was not given to increase our knowledge, but to change our lives. The scholar, Dr. A.W. Pink, said to realize that the Holy Scriptures are a revelation from the Most High, communicating to us His mind and defining for us His will, is the first step toward practical godliness. To recognize that the Bible is God's Word and that its precepts are the precepts of the Almighty, will lead us to see what an awful thing it is to despise and ignore them. Let's pray. Holy Father God in heaven, I pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Lord, I thank you for the confidence that you give us in prayer, based upon your holy word that says, ask and ye shall receive, seek and ye shall find, knock and it shall be opened unto you. Lord God in heaven, I believe your holy word. As you know, Lord, we are weak and feeble. And so we pray that you would grant us spiritual and mental and physical strength. Renew, Lord, us again. Revive us again. Grant me and all of us the power, the unction, and the anointing of your Holy Spirit to read your holy word and to understand it and to apply it to our lives, to hide it in our hearts,